The Higgs boson has been discovered at the LHC, and the work of Professors Englert and Higgs has now been awarded with the Nobel Prize. So, are we finished with Higgs physics? Well, the answer to that is no. While the particle at the LHC looks a lot like we expect the Higgs boson to behave, it could be that in detail it behaves in a quite different way. For example, in the standard model, we've seen that these are the most important decays of the Higgs boson. We need to go out and check to see if the Higgs actually does decay like this. The standard model gives detailed numerical predictions for precisely how important each of these decays is, so there's a lot of detailed work to do to see if the Higgs boson really is behaving as physicists expect. Discovering the Higgs boson has been a triumph for particle physics. But there is much more going on in the universe that we don't understand. Cosmological observations have taught us that the universe is filled with a kind of dark matter, that is a stable, feebly interacting particle, which we don't understand. In addition, we don't understand why the universe around us is made mostly of matter. There doesn't seem to be any appreciable amounts of antimatter in the universe. We don't understand the details of this. Since there's so much going on that we don't understand, it makes sense for us to think of more refined descriptions of physics, which would supersede the standard model. That'll be the topic of today's talk. In the standard model, electroweak symmetry is broken because the Higgs field takes on a vacuum expectation value, which is different from zero. One possibility for physics beyond the standard model is that instead of just one Higgs field breaking electroweak symmetry, there are two Higgs fields, each of which breaks electroweak symmetry. This model, known as the two Higgs doublet model, has two Higgs fields, which we call H1 and H2. H1 takes on a vacuum expectation value, V1, and H2 takes on a vacuum expectation value, V2. Let's take a moment to look at the number of particle states in this two Higgs doublet model. Before electroweak symmetry breaking, many things are just like we saw before. The massless W plus, W minus, and W3 contribute a total of 3 times 2, which is 6 states. The massless B just contributes 2 states. Now there are two Higgs fields, each of which contributes 4 states. So there's a total of 16 states in this model before electroweak symmetry breaking. After electroweak symmetry breaking, of course, there must still be 16 states. These are made up, as before, of a massive W plus and W minus, contributing 6 states, a massive Z boson, contributing 3 states, the massless photon, which contributes 2. So the remaining number of states are Higgs particles. In this two Higgs doublet model, there are a total of 5 Higgs particles in nature. So in two Higgs doublet model, we've only just scratched the surface of Higgs physics. There are 4 more Higgs particles to be discovered. One interesting thing about two Higgs doublet models is that they're required by one of the most exciting theories for beyond the standard model physics, which is known as supersymmetry. In the standard model, there are 2 basic classes of particles. These are the bosons and the fermions. Examples of bosons are photons, and of course the Higgs boson and the Z boson. Simple examples of fermions include the electrons and the quarks. The basic idea of supersymmetry is that there's a new symmetry in nature, which is a symmetry between bosons and fermions. Now, since there are no fermions that behave, for example, like the photon, and there are no bosons that behave, for example, like the electron, to implement supersymmetry, we introduce new classes of particles. So for each boson in the standard model, we introduce a fermionic superpartner. For example, the photon has a supersymmetric partner, which we call the photino in supersymmetric theories. Similarly, for each fermion, we introduce a bosonic partner. So for the electron, for example, we introduce a superpartner called the selectron, which is a boson. For the quarks, there's a superpartner, which we call the squarks. So in supersymmetry, since there's a Higgs boson in nature, we have to find some Higgs fermions. So there's a whole new kind of Higgs particle to be discovered in supersymmetric theories. Supersymmetry is a symmetry, so there are many different ways we can implement it in physical theories. Most of our interest has been on a theory called the minimally supersymmetric standard model, or the MSSM for short. In the MSSM, there is a new kind of charge called the Oort charge, which is exactly conserved. This exact conservation means that just like the electric charge, in any process, the OR charge before is equal to the OR charge after. Let's see how this works in a simple process involving just the electric charge. For example, we can consider a process where an up quark splits into a down quark and a W. Before the process, the charge is the charge in the up quark, which is 2/3. After the process, the charge is the charge of the down quark, which is -1/3, plus the charge of the W. So to balance these charges, I better say that the W is positively charged. So it contributes +1. The charge before is 2/3. The charge after is 2/3. So the electric charge has been conserved. OR charge behaves in much the same way. One difference is that to compute the electric charge of a composite state involving a bunch of different particles, you just go and add the electric charge of the separate particles. To compute the OR charge of a composite system, we multiply the OR charges of the individual particles. OR charge is assigned to particles in the MSSM in a very simple way. The OR charge of all standard model particles is +1, and the OR charge of all the new superpartners is -1. So let's see this OR charge working. Here's an example of a process. It's a familiar process involving a Higgs decaying to 2 quarks. The OR charge of the Higgs is +1. After the process, we have to compute the OR charge of the 2 quarks. Since each quark has OR charge +1, the total OR charge after the process is +1 × +1, which is again +1. So the OR charge before the process is equal to the OR charge after. Here's another example of a process in the MSSM. In this case, the process involves a H tilde, the Higgsino, decaying to a Q tilde, which is a quark, and a quark. The OR charge before the process is the OR charge of the Higgsino, which is -1, since it's a superpartner. After the process, the total OR charge is the OR charge of the quark, which is -1, times the OR charge of a quark, which is +1. So the total OR charge after the process is -1, which again balances the process. Conservation of OR charge has an extremely important consequence in the MSSM. One superpartner must be the lightest superpartner. We call this lightest superpartner the LSP. Since the LSP is the lightest superpartner, the only way it can decay would be to standard model particles. They're the only things that are sufficiently light to allow the LSP to decay into them. However, let's consider the conservation of OR charge. Before the process occurs, the OR charge is -1 for the LSP. After the process, no matter how many standard model particles the LSP decays to, the OR charge would be +1. This is because each standard model particle contributes +1 to the final OR charge. Now, since OR charge must be conserved, the OR charge after the process must be -1 in any physical process. Since it's not, this process simply isn't allowed. That means that the LSP is exactly stable. So we've learned that in the MSSM, the lightest supersymmetric partner, the LSP, is stable. In fact, you can arrange parameters in the MSSM so that the LSP has the properties you'd expect of dark matter. This is one of the reasons why supersymmetric theories are so exciting. They automatically predict dark matter particles. So now we've considered two possibilities for physics beyond the standard model. The first thing we talked about was the two Higgs doublet model, where there are entirely new fundamental Higgs particles to be discovered. We also talked about supersymmetry, in which there are new fundamental Higgs fermions to be discovered. But another possibility for physics beyond the standard model is that in fact there are no fundamental Higgs particles in nature. These theories are called composite Higgs models. The basic idea is that the Higgs, like the proton, is made up of some more fundamental particles. The motivation for this is quite simple. We've never discovered a fundamental scalar particle before. So scalar particles are something that are really new in nature. That's not to say that we've never seen any scalar particle before. It's just that we've never seen fundamental scalar particles before. In fact, there have been plenty of scalar particles discovered. For example, in 1947 in Bristol, a trio of scalar particles called pions were discovered. Pions, like protons, are made up of quarks. An example is the pi plus, which is made up of an up quark and an anti-down quark. Holding the pion together is a bunch of gluons. It could be that the Higgs boson is quite similar. It's a scalar particle which is made up of some more fundamental components. A specific example of this is a theory called technicolor. Technicolor is modeled on quantum chromodynamics, our theory of how the proton is made up. In technicolor, the Higgs is made up in a pretty similar way to the pions. Inside it are techniquarks. One techniquark and one anti-techniquark, so that the net charge of this whole thing is zero. Now, if technicolor is realized in nature, we expect that we can discover a whole slew of new particles if we collide protons with sufficiently large energy. Again, this is just like what would happen in nuclear physics. When we take protons and smash them together at low energies, then first not much happens, but then we start to release pions and more complicated particles which are made up of quarks. In technicolor, if we smash particles together with sufficiently large energies, we could make more and more complicated systems made up of technigluons and techniquarks.